Okay, so in today's video, we're going to go ahead and install the simple vision camera onto our robot. And basically what we have on the table in front of us are a couple of the tools that we're going to need, a Phillips head screwdriver, an Allen wrench kit, the camera itself, and then next to the camera there are the cable ties that tie it to the robot head, the small screwdriver that's used to adjust the light intensity, and then right next to this is the bracket for mounting it to the robot. So if we zoom in a little bit here, you can see that bracket has a nice long slot on the back rail. But the beauty of the bracket is that it is completely configurable. So right now, if you look, the camera mount is to the right of the 90-degree leg, and what we're going to do is we're probably going to flip that over and put it on the opposite side, so it'll be on the left-hand side of that rail before we put it on the robot. And the reason for that is I want the maximum amount of distance between the camera and the dispense solution mounted on the robot. So we'll see that in the next video. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and turn the bracket around. Basically just loosen the screw. And again, this is on a slide. Everything on this bracket is adjustable. So we're basically going to back that screw and washer off. And the bracket is universal, so there is no top and bottom for this assembly. We're just going to slide it over to the opposite side and then put the screw back in it. And again, if you look, this is slotted. So there's a lot of adjustability here. Generally, I like to have them out near flush to the end of the rail, so we'll set it there for now. Okay, nice and tight, so we're ready to go on to the robot. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and we're going to install the simple vision bracket onto our dispense bracket. Before we do that, we're just going to make sure that the robot is e-stopped so that everything can be moving by hand. Alright, and then what we'll do is I'll work on the back of the robot here. There are two screws on the side of the bracket that loosen it. So let's go ahead and crack those while we've got it off the robot. Okay, so now this is a little loose. I can lift that up and down. And then I'm going to use the bolt with the washer that came with the kit, and we're going to mount it to the back of our bracket. The bracket has multiple slots on it, so you pick a slot that you think is going to work well for the setup you're using. I've got a syringe bracket on here right now. So basically I'm going to set it fairly high, put the screw in the hole, and then I like to adjust it so it's sitting a little further out, because again, I don't want to bump the camera when I'm taking the adapter head off of the top of the syringe. So I want it out to max travel. And it really doesn't matter how far out this is, because the tip to camera offset's going to compensate for those two physical locations. The idea here is I don't want anything, when I'm working with this, I don't want to be hitting this camera at all, because every time I do that, I may mess up what I was just doing in terms of focus. All right, so there it is. It's all mounted, ready to go. Okay, so now I have my simple vision camera ready to go on the robot, ready to go on the bracket. And basically, I'm not going to worry about the cable for right now. I'm just going to make sure I don't damage it, obviously. But basically, all I'm going to do is I'm going to take the diffuser off the end of the camera, because it'll make it easier to slide it into the bracket. So I've already loosened the two collar bolts, and that should allow me to slide this in. If not, I'll give it a little, back it out a little bit further. You don't want to wrestle with it going in. You want to be able to slide it up and down. All right, so what I'm looking for here is the height between my dispense tip, which should be sitting down here somewhere, and this camera. Typically, I want that camera 5 to 10 millimeters above the tip. But again, this is an adjustable camera, so leaving it this high isn't a problem. I will tighten it right where it is for now until we do the test to make sure it's aligned. So I'm not really cranking on it. It's not fully secured at this point, because again, I want to check and make sure that I'm squared up with the fixture plate and the tip detect device before I suck that down and fully tighten it. All right, the next step in the process, we'll put the diffuser back on. and that just snaps over the end of the lens. Done. Now, the next step of this is where we get into a little bit of confusion on a lot of customer sites. This camera requires an adequate service loop, meaning that as this camera is moving up and down, you know, I've got this robot sitting on standoffs, but basically this robot needs to be able to go down all the way to the fixture plate and come up without this camera getting a lot of side load. Okay, this is, you know, this camera connection here, you know, you really don't want to be flexing it left, right. You want it going straight up and down. So we're going to go over the steps involved in dressing this cable and providing that service loop right now. Notice that I've got the cable loose in my hand. I'm not doing anything yet with dressing it into the robot. What I'm going to do is I'm going to drop it over the back of the robot and just let it uncoil, let it just dangle sitting there. Okay, and the reason for that is this camera cable has a lot of memory in it. So I want that, it's kind of like coiling up a garden hose or an extension cord. I want to work that memory out. I want that camera cable to go exactly where I want it. And the best way to do that is to secure one end, leave the other end loose, and then we'll attach it to the side of the robot. Okay, so one of the elements of this that we need to do is we're going to take out the three Z-head cover screws temporarily, and we've got three cable clamps that we're going to use to route that cable along the head of the robot. And typically, if you look at this, these are fixed cable clamps. These are screwed in. So you have to basically remove the screws to take the cable back out, which is a good thing because I don't necessarily want to be doing that. I want to do the camera as a fixed asset. I don't want to keep changing the cable mount. I don't want to add stuff to it. I don't want to take the bolts out and take the chance that I twist the cable and then create the memory that I just was trying to eliminate. So we'll work on this side for the camera, and then everything else in terms of dispense infrastructure will be on this side of the robot head. So we'll leave this cable alone. It'll be sitting here by itself, and that'll help preserve what we're about to do. Okay, so we're just about ready to install our camera cable. What I've done is I've removed the three original screws that were holding the Z-head cover on this side. And you'll notice that the screws that come with the kit are a little bit longer. That's how you know that they're used with these clamps. The clamps obviously have a little bit of thickness to them, so the added length just allows us to fully tighten everything. So these three screws, we'll put these aside and save them for a rainy day, and these are the three that we're going to be putting in. Okay, so now we're about ready to dress up camera cable. We've got the three bolts removed from the side. We've got our new hardware sitting here. We've got our cable dressed up and over, and it's loose. There's nothing hanging. It's not connected to anything. We're going to just Z the robot down. Again, we're in e-stop, so I can move everything freely. So that gives me some sense of how much reach I'm going to need. Assuming there's a tip on the end of this, I'm going to have a loop that can do this much reach. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my hand here, and I'm just going to flex this down a little bit. And then I'm going to let it come up. Okay, so that gives me some sense of how much loop I'm going to need. See, now there's some memory there. See how that wanted to twist? So we're going to spin this camera cable to make that go away. I'm not going to lose position. I'm just going to spin it. Get it off the head here. That's a little better. Okay, so that is pretty much what I want to do. You saw me wrestling with it for a minute, but again, that's going to happen with the amount of memory. These cables come in all coiled up, so it takes, you know, a little bit of effort. But once you've got it to this point, we're in pretty good shape. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab one of my three clamps, slide it over the cable, and just slide it over the poles, screw. Let's get this in the bowl first, and then we'll worry about the cable. There we go. Okay, so just... Alright, so I'll put my hand out of the way a little bit. Alright, not super tight, because we're not quite there yet. Okay, so now we have our first clamp on our camera cable. And if I Z the robot up and down, I've got a nice dress here with the camera cable. Again, I'm not twisting it side to side. It's going straight up and down, which is really what I prefer to see. Okay, so now I've got two of my clamps in. And we'll go ahead and install the third one. All right, so at this point, I've got all my clamps in. Got a nice motion on the cable. The next step is going to be to dress this camera cable around the top of the Z head and down this tractor to the back of the robot. Now, before we do that, one of the things we can do is make sure that the camera is aligned over the tip detect device. And what we can do to do that is simply plug this in and we'll power up the robot and turn the vision system on so we can see exactly what the camera is seeing. Again, I'm not going to dress it until I've got that squared away because it may require that I change something here. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and we're going to dress this camera cable down through the robot tractor. And this is very similar to what we did when we were mounting the air mount bracket and the Pico cables. So basically I'm going to pull on the tab on the tractor and lift this tractor up. Probably a third of its travel. Drape it on the side. And then we're just going to take this camera cable and we're going to carefully slide the USB end down the track. And this is a little snug because we've got the Pico cables in there, but if you look, I'm moving the Z head of the robot to make sliding the camera cable a little bit easier. Use your fingers a little bit to help guide it. Again, with all the other infrastructure on this robot right now, it's getting a little snug. So be patient, take your time. Notice I'm not having to unbolt the tractor like I did for the Pico cables because this connector is small enough. Give it a little wiggle. All right, and here we go. So, camera's emerging, the cable's coming out the other end. A little flip. All right, so we are good to go. And then all we're going to do is we're going to close the tractor back up. Drape it back over itself. One connection at a time.